So Rusty's had about 5 minutes now in this bit, maybe 10. He's seems pretty comfortable with it. He's messing with it and chewing, and so that makes me feel like he's got some comfort level. I'm gonna go ahead and put the reins over his head now. And anytime I introduce a new bit to the horse, before I ride him, I wanna show him what pressure on that bit is gonna feel like. Down here on the ground where he doesn't have to think too hard and he can just focus on that. I don't have to think too hard, I can focus on it too. So with the reins over the head, I'm going to shorten both reins, and then I'm just gonna take a little bit of contact on the bit and then lock my hands down on his neck. And because he immediately gave the correct answer, I'm gonna release the rein. So that's what I was looking for. So I'm gonna take contact, even contact on both reins. I'm gonna lock my hands onto the neck so that when he flexes at the pole and gives to the pressure, he gets an automatic release. So we'll do that again. So I'll take contact and then lock my hands, and then I'll wait for him to put slack in the reins. So. Good boy. All right, good boy. Okay. He thought that seemed suspiciously like a cue to back up. That's fine. But I just waited and I tried to make him understand I wasn't asking him to back up. So I'm just gonna take a little lighter contact now. Well, I want him to understand that it is the giving to the pressure and not the backing up that is going to give him a release. Good boy. So he is doing fine with the contact on this bit. He's doing fine with the nose pressure, the nose band. So again, he is already a trained horse. Good boy. So this was not introducing the combination bit to a horse that's never been bridled. This was introducing the combination bit to a trained horse that's already used to a different bridle.